Hello and welcome. In this series of videos, we are going to take a look at the CDEF programming language and how to solve problems from the Project Euler website. First problem, we have a list of, we are asked to find the sum of all the numbers below 1000 which are multiples of 3 or 5. Okay, so usually in this series we are going to write very short programs. So we have below 1000, we do the dot caret operator, and each number we map it to n, and then we say n must be divisible by 3, so this is the is divisible operator, or n is divisible by 5. So if this is true, we add this number n, otherwise we add 0. So if we execute this program, we get this answer here, and the answer is correct. Okay, so this is one solution. I'm going to show you a few more solutions. Let's see. So I'm going to delete this one actually. So we can say also for n 1 to 999, and if n we can say divides 3 divides, let's do this, 3 divides n, right? So this is an expression, or 5, let's put in parentheses, 5 divides n. So if this is true, we need to create a new variable which is sum, and we add this number n. So var sum is initially 0, and then we print here the sum at the end. If you execute the program again, you get exactly the same result, the same answer. Alright, so this is one way to do it. So this divides, it's a method, but we call it as an infix operator, which shows that CDEF is quite a flexible language. Another way, another solution will be to just make a range. So from, let's use the caret one again, so from 1 below 1000, and we say grep each number that this is divisible by 3 or this is divisible by 5. And then we just print the sum of this. So this is another short solution, and as you can see, we get the same answer, right? So if you say what is below 10,000, we happily get another result. And if you continue, you can actually see a pattern, and you can optimize this process to not count, to not iterate over all this range of numbers. Yeah, so this is very simple to get started to the Project Euler website. So solving this problem with iteration, it's not a big problem, not a big deal, because 1000 it's fairly small numbers for computers to deal with, so that's not an issue. But if this number was, let's say, 10 to the 12 or 10 to the 20, then you had to find a pattern and just sum those multiples of 3 and 5. And there are problems which are similar to this, the Hamming numbers, which only have factors of less than a certain limit and so on. But we are going to those problems in a future, maybe. So that's it for this one, and we'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.